Hey everybody, I am Acharkan and welcome to another one of my videos. If you saw my video with Dragon Ball Talks, with a comparison about Legends and Dokkan, then I assume that this video comes as no surprise. Yes, I have also started to play Dokkan, because I really believe this is the best moment when you can start a game at the game anniversary. With all of the things that the game is providing, plus the fact that in the story mode you just scroll through the game without actual any difficulty and you are able to gather those stones, then it is the perfect time. However, there is one problem. With great power comes great boredom. I am at rank 37, I am going through the story mode extremely easy, but because I'm going through it extremely easy, it is extremely boring. However, the good part is that I do not have to worry about details. Right now, with whatever I got, I was able to progress without any problems, and I was able to gather the stones that you have there. And because it is anniversary time, we have some interesting banners. Now, this anniversary is going to be longer, but for now, as a first step, yeah, I know, we don't have these tickets yet, we will get them in time. But we have this multi-summon. 55 special summons with one character, at least one, that is a guaranteed LR. Now, for me, this is the moment where I am 100% sure that it is impossible to get shafted. You know why? Simple, because I don't have anything. Whatever I get, it's awesome. And whatever I get, I'm going to use as a basis in order to build a team and from there to actually progress. Right now, I can only do the story modes. The quests are really difficult because the game actually tells me that I stand no chance. Do you want to actually try it anyway? Very, very funny. So we have the multi-summon and we have also this summon. I'm going to start with this one and after that I will move to the big one. Let's go ahead with my first ever Dokkan summon. Going for it. Now, obviously, I'm not really used to the animations, but whatever SSR character, it's very good. That's all I know for now. I really want SSRs because from what I saw, the roster is huge. And we have an SR in Majin Buu. Ranks. And here it is, Cell. I have no idea who this one is. Another Trunks. So just like that, my roster is much more powerful and it's so funny. Now, if I compare this to Legends, it's so very funny because with Legends, I started from almost the beginning of the game and there I am exactly where I think I should be. I have a really big roster, I have almost all of the characters in the game and there I can actually focus on teams and tags and synergy and so on. But here, ooh, another SR Goten! Because I have nothing, it's so much easier for me to analyze the game. Because right now, there is no pressure, there's not like I have to do stuff, no. I'm just waiting to see what I'm getting and then I will start to worry about future synergies and what teams I can make and so on. Of course, I saw that we are going to have Super Saiyan Blue Vegito and Gogeta. If I'm going to be able to get any of those two, it's going to be awesome. I'm going to tell you from the start that I'm going to focus on Gogeta simply because I have Vegito in Legends. Yeah, I know that's not an argument, but that's what I am going to do. But if we are serious, from what I checked about them, Vegito seems to be more of a defensive type, while Gogeta he can be included in more teams. But more on that one if I actually am able to ever get them. Until then, it is time for this one, the big summon. 55 powerful characters to your team. Going for it. And basically this is how my adventure in the Dokkan battle actually starts. With a summon, a big summon, from the 5th anniversary. Very good. Of course I know that I have a guaranteed SSR, guaranteed LR, sorry. But which one is it going to be? Great Salmon. Aww, Jiaozu! Oops. So far I have gotten a lot of Trunkses. Yamcha! R! Bardock! SSR! Very good. Right now, I think in my current team, I only have one SSR. Yeah, even if I won't have any synergy, these guys, all of these guys are going into my main team. I really want to grow my team and actually be able to do some missions, because only with the story mode, on one hand it's pretty relaxing because, well, no pressure and stuff like that. On the other hand, I want to do interesting stuff. Of course it is impossible for me to catch up with you guys that have been playing this for years, but I will do my best. Ooh, Angry Boo. So many combinations, so many characters. Ooh, Majin Vegeta, SSR, very, very good. As I told you guys, for me, it is impossible to get shafted in this banner. So far, I think everything that I summoned today is a new character for me. Very good, another SSR in Trunks. Hello, Tien. Android. Kagoma. I actually forgot the name from Super. Another Android. The good part is that after I'm done with this summon, I'm actually going to be able to spend all of the equipments that I gathered so far. One thing, in case any of you guys want to also start a game, do not spend your materials if you're not sure what you're doing there. Very, very important. Now, this game has been around for 5 years. There is a reason for that. Although it may look easy, if you spend all the materials that you're getting at the beginning for nothing, you might realize at some point that, oh my god, I've done such a big mistake. I should have boosted this guy, not those guys, and right now I don't have materials and I have to grind and blah 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 blah. Really be careful. Wait a little bit, just play the game, enjoy it, and when you're sure on where you want to spend your materials, then push. Do not look at the big guys that have thousands and thousands of materials which they don't really need because they have been playing the game for such a long time. No. That is the biggest challenges for us new players, to actually invest in the units that are going to be relevant and useful in order for us to grow much faster. So that is why I actually took my time. I knew that I was waiting for the anniversary event because I wanted to grow as fast as possible. That doesn't mean that I am expecting to be from one day to the other, but slowly, patiently, and with a little bit of strategy, I hope to actually grow my roster in a short amount of time. Let's see if I'm able to do that. As I said earlier, it would be pretty nice if I can actually get a Super Saiyan Blue Gogeta. Really nice, because then, yeah, if I have that one, and I would... Ooh, Nice, Deborah. If I can actually have some main characters, which I am sure that they are extremely good, it would be so much easier to build a team around them. But now, one of the ideas that I had is that I'm going to see what is my guaranteed character from here, and if I like him and I want to be okay. So BoJack it is. Not exactly what I was expecting, and it was the last one. It was the last one. Okay, so BoJack can be upgraded to LR. This is not exactly what I was expecting. This caught me by surprise, because I do not want to go for a movie theme. I am assuming that some of the tags are similar to Legends, but I don't want to go for this. I was thinking about, of course, something like Fusion, Future, stuff like that. Somewhere where I can include the future Blue Boys. Back to the drawing board. However, for now, this looks pretty, pretty good. That means that I will have to change my team, because this is very funny. This is my team so far. So basically, I'm going to replace Chi-Chi, the androids, and the Saiyan Man with SSR characters. And then after that, I will see how I will proceed in order to have the strongest team I can. Thank you guys for watching. This has been my Summon, and until next time, I am Archarchon. See you later, guys.